hydrologic cycle we have done, the components of hydrologic cycle, evaporation, water vapor moves upwards, cloud formation, condensation, precipitation, interception, infiltration, runoff, deep percolation, groundwater. These are the components of the hydrologic cycle. And one of the important component is the evaporation. As has been seen, that it is the change of the state of the liquid from liquid state to the gaseous state, but it is below the boiling point. This change needs an heat energy of 585 calories for each gram of the water if of evaporation. It is expressed in millimeters per day, centimeters per day, as we express the precipitation as well as we express the infiltration, because we want all these in depths so that they should be brought on one platform. Evaporation or the evaporation, evapotranspiration, they are very important phases of the hydrologic cycle. They distribute and redistribute the heat energy between the water surface or the soil surface and the atmosphere. It's a continuous natural process. As has been discussed, the liquid changes to gaseous state, and the main source for this state change is solar radiation. And it's a matter of very serious concern that 90% of the annual precipitation in arid region like the desert, etc., gets evaporated. So we are losing how much quantity of the water, that you can understand. The mechanism of evaporation, wherein at the surface of the water body, due to the external thermal energy supplied through the solar rays, the water molecules at the surface of the water body gets kinetic energy, they get energized, and due to their energy gain, they start movement, they get excited, and they try to escape from the water body, overcoming the intermolecular force of attraction, and they eject themselves into the atmosphere. This is called as the evaporation. And the amount of the heat that has been taken by the water molecule to get ejected or to get evaporated is either from the atmosphere or from the water itself. That heat is called as the latent heat of the evaporation, vaporization, or the vaporation. Okay, it is denoted by L, capital L. And when the external energy is not available, means if atmospheric temperature is too cool, too cold to give the energy to the water molecule at the surface, the water molecule at the surface gains the energy from the water itself and try to overcome the intermolecular force of attraction of the water molecules and try to escape from the water surface, and wherein it reduces the temperature of the water body. It's very good example is the cooling of the water in the soil container, or what we call it as a soil matka, mati ka matka jisko bolte hai, jisme pani thanda hota hai. The only reason is the evaporation, and wherein through the pores of that soil pot, through the pores of that soil pot, the water percolates. It tries to come out. It tries to change its state from liquid to gas, liquid to vapor, and it absorbs the water. It absorbs the temperature. It absorbs the heat from that pot, and thereby we get the cooled water or the cold water in the earthen pot. Okay. So evaporation is nothing but indirectly we can say it's the method of cooling, or it's the cooling process. A very important concept is the vapor pressure. At the surface of the water body, two pressures act. One permanent is the atmospheric pressure, and the another, when these water molecules gets converted into the vapor molecules, they gets accumulated over the water surface, and slowly their density increases, and this accumulation of the water molecules creates a pressure on the water surface. So this pressure by the vapor molecule as well as the pressure by the atmosphere together is called as the vapor pressure, a very important concept. Continuous supply of the heat energy from the atmosphere or from the water itself continues the evaporation process, continues the accumulation of the water vapor molecule over the surface of the water, and slowly they, due to the force of the cohesion between the water molecules, they come very close together. That process is called as the condensation, and this condensation process continues, and at certain point due this condensed water vapor molecules or this rate of the condensation is same as the rate of vaporization. The meaning is that the condensed or accumulated vapor molecules over the surface of the earth, over the surface of the water pressure, water surface of the water body, creates a pressure. And this pressure is so much, which we call it as the condensed vapor molecules pressure. This pressure is so much that it does not allow more water molecules to get converted into the vapor. That you can call it as the rate of the condensation is same as the vaporization. At this stage, we can say, technically we say, that now the air is saturated, means air is composed of, air means air which is adjacent to water surface is composed of so much vapor molecules that it now does not allow more vapor molecules to get produced from the water surface, and this state is called as the saturated state of the air at the surface of the water. At this saturation, the partial pressure exerted by the water vapor is called as the saturation vapor pressure. Okay, we have learnt what is the vapor pressure, that is the pressure due to the water vapor plus atmospheric pressure, and now the saturation vapor pressure, that is again same, that is atmospheric pressure plus the water vapor pressure, but only water vapor pressure at the point of saturation. Means when the maximum water vapor has now condensed and is not allowing more water molecules to get evaporated, to get converted into the water vapor. This saturation vapor pressure is denoted by ES. And this saturation vapor pressure can increase with the increase in atmospheric temperature, because as the temperature increases, the density of the air decreases, and the decrease in density of air will accumulate more water vapor, and therefore for to reach the condensation state, it will need more vapor molecule, so therefore it will allow more vaporization of the water. So this state where the saturation vapor pressure or the condensation of the vapor molecules and the evaporation stoppage due to the condensation, that is when the saturation vapor pressure and condensation pressure is also same, then where the neither the evaporation nor condensation takes place, this is called as the equilibrium state. This is actually theoretical state. The 100% equilibrium state does not exist. Okay, so if the vapor pressure of the air above the free surface of the water body is already equal to the saturation vapor pressure, then Neither evaporation nor condensation takes place, and then it is called as the equilibrium state. But as I have told you just now, that this never exists in actual under natural conditions, because the various other atmospheric components like the temperature, wind, atmospheric pressure, they are all not constant. They vary from time to time, from second to second. So therefore, this equilibrium state wherein the saturation vapor pressure is equal to the vapor pressure actually existing, then that equilibrium state, that is called as that, it never exists in actual under natural conditions, as the atmosphere into which evaporation takes place is infinite, and various transport processes means wind, etc., will also operate to transport the vapor in atmosphere, both parallel and perpendicular to the liquid surface. यानी वर्टिकली भी ऊपर जाएगी वेपर और हॉरिजॉन्टली भी जाए बहेगी, तो इसलिए क्या है कि फिर से नई वेपर आने के लिए वहां पे जगह बनती है, और ऐसे थियोरेटिकली तो इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट होगी, लेकिन प्रैक्टिकली ऐसी इक्विलिब्रियम स्टेट आना नामुमकिन है. लेकिन हमारे अंडरस्टैंडिंग के लिए, समझने के लिए, ये हमें एक वी मस्ट नो दिस कंसेप्ट so as to compare this equilibrium state with the other parameters that we'll be learning in the due course of the discussion. So, and prevent equilibrium from occurring. All these natural parameters like the wind, like the temperature, like the atmospheric pressure, the wind velocity, wind direction, etc. Okay. Now, what are the parameters necessary for the evaporation to occur? The first and foremost is the supply of water, because without supply of water, evaporation cannot take place. We need a source of heat, because heat is must, water is must. Vapor pressure deficit is very important. We want that the atmospheric or the vapor pressure, natural vapor pressure. Vapor pressure, again I will repeat, the atmospheric pressure plus the pressure created by the vapor, and this vapor pressure is at the surface of the water body. This vapor pressure should always be less than the saturation vapor pressure. Okay, means if it is equal to saturation vapor pressure, no evaporation will take place. Saturation vapor pressure say नॉर्मल या नेचुरल वेपर प्रेशर जो है वो हरदम कम रहना चाहिए, तो ही इवेपोरेशन होगा, है ना. सीधी सी बात है कि सैचुरेशन कब होता है, आपके ध्यान में आ गया, कि जब ज्यादा वेपर मॉलिक्यूल एक्यूमुलेट ही नहीं कर सकता, वो जमा ही नहीं कर सकता, तो सैचुरेशन होगा. तो यदि इफ सैचुरेटेड वेपर इज देयर एट द टॉप ऑफ वाटर बॉडी, देन इट कैन नॉट एक्सेप्ट मोर वेपर मॉलिक्यूल्स, मीन्स इट विल रेजिस्ट द इवेपोरेशन. So always the vapor pressure above the surface of the water body should be less than the saturation vapor pressure, then only the evaporation will take place. That is the difference between the saturated vapor pressure of the water, ES, corresponding to water temperature, and the actual vapor pressure of the air above the free surface, EA. Okay, so this difference must be there. If it is not there, what will happen? Now the next, based on this saturation vapor pressure and the actual evaporation process, evaporation pressure or the vapor pressure, one law has been formulated by Mr. Dalton. He is a specialist in the heat energy. He formulated this law of evaporation in 1802. Wherein he stated that evaporation is proportional to the vapor pressure deficit. Which deficit? That is the difference between the saturation vapor pressure and the normal vapor pressure. That is ES minus EA. This we have seen. that is the vapor pressure deficit, ES minus EA, if it is available, then and only then evaporation will take place. So this has been simply stated by Mr. Dalton in his law of the evaporation. Very important. As I have been telling you, these things are also asked in the question form in your exam. So the Dalton's law of evaporation in mathematical form is written that rate of evaporation can be related to the vapor pressure, as the rate of evaporation E is equal to C multiplied by ES minus EA, which is equal to A plus B into V into ES minus EA, wherein the E is the evaporation loss or the evaporation rate, that is millimeters per day, millimeters per hour, millimeters per minute, or millimeter per second. ES is the saturation vapor pressure, that is the vapor pressure created at the surface of the water body at the point of saturation, means no more water or vapor molecule can be accommodated. This vapor pressure is denoted in millibar, like the atmospheric pressure. EA is the actual vapor pressure of the air above the surface of the water body. C is the constant whose value depends on various factors such as the barometric, that is the atmospheric pressure, the wind velocity, humidity, etc. C is equal to A plus B into V, wherein A, B are constant and V is the wind velocity in kilometers per hour. This is simple a Dalton's law of evaporation. Now, very important that this rate of evaporation, E, friends, again, three things I will relate to this rate of evaporation, which is again denoted in centimeter or millimeters per day. I will relate this to again rainfall intensity, which is again centimeters per hour, per minute, per day. Again, infiltration rate, it is also denoted in centimeters or millimeters per day, per hour. And also we can relate this to the runoff. This runoff also it can be expressed in depth that we have seen in our last phi and W index numerical, wherein the total runoff, if divided by the catchment area, then we can get the runoff in the depth, expressed in depth over that catchment area. Because total runoff is expressed in cubic meter divided by the square meter, that is the area, will give you the meter, that is the depth of the runoff over the catchment area. So all the things that is from rainfall intensity, the infiltration rate or the infiltration capacity, the runoff, we can also express the runoff in the runoff rate also per unit time. And now the rate of the evaporation on the same platform, on the same scale. And now it is how it is expressed by the Dalton's law that we have seen. From this equation, we can see that evaporation can continue only when this actual vapor pressure or the normal vapor pressure EA is always less than saturation or saturated vapor pressure. EA should be less than ES. Evaporation will increase at a more and more rate when ES and EA is too large. Means saturation, now the actual vapor pressure is too small compared to the saturation vapor pressure, so evaporation must to jyada rahega. Evaporation will be zero when the saturation air pressure or the vapor pressure is equal to the normal vapor pressure. Means EA has reached ES value or saturation vapor pressure ho gaya hai. So naturally, जब मॉइस्चर एकोमोडेट करने के लिए जगह ही नहीं है तो इवेपोरेशन विल नॉट टेक प्लेस. this has been very simply expressed in the Dalton's law of the evaporation. Now, friends, we'll be moving on to the next part, that is the factors affecting the evaporation losses. Very simple and based on the common sense. The first is nature and size of the evaporating surface. Nature and size of the evaporating surface, that is the surface of the water body, or maybe surface of the soil also, because evaporation not only takes place on the surface of the water body, but it also takes place on the surface of the wet soil surface, wet soil mass. Okay, so nature and size of the evaporating surface, we'll see one by one. Then area of the water surface, more the area of water surface, more it is exposed to the solar energy, to the heat energy, to the more temperature, more will be evaporation. Depth of water in the water body, lesser the depth, more is the evaporation. More the depth, lesser is the evaporation. So depth of water body and area of water surface are very important from the point of view of the evaporation. Humidity, atmospheric moisture content, we call it as the humidity. So humidity is also very important. More the humidity, lesser the evaporation. Lesser the humidity, more the evaporation. Again, relate to saturation vapor pressure. More humidity, more saturation vapor pressure, lesser will be the evaporation. Wind velocity. More wind velocity, more movement of the evaporated vapor molecules. More movement of the evaporated vapor molecules, more is the space for the again evaporated, accommodating the vapor molecules. So more evaporation. Lesser wind velocity, lesser evaporation. Air and water temperature, again, you know that latent heat of the for evaporation or the vaporization. So temperature plays an important role. More atmospheric temperature, more evaporation. More water temperature also helps in more evaporation. Lesser atmospheric or water temperature, lesser evaporation. Atmospheric pressure and the vapor pressure at the surface and above, air above, atmospheric pressure, more, lesser evaporation. Atmospheric pressure less, more evaporation. Vapor pressure again plays. Vapor pressure consists of the two pressures, that is the atmospheric pressure, but pressure created by the vapor. Don't confuse vapor pressure with only vapor pressure created by vapor. Okay, vapor pressure is the combination of the atmospheric pressure plus the pressure created by the water vapor from the surface of the water body, or maybe from the surface of the wet soil. Okay, from the surface of the wet earth, you can say. So atmospheric pressure and vapor pressure definitely plays a very important role in the evaporation or the vaporization. Quality of water, okay. No, saline water, salty water, more energy needed for the vaporization. Fresh water, non-saline water, lesser energy needed for the evaporation. And the solar radiation, definitely more the sun or more the sun hours for the available in the daytime, more is the evaporation. So the meteorological factor, just now we have seen all these total 9 factors. Again, I will repeat, or I expect that you are sitting with your notebook and the pen and noting down all these things, as has been informed to you, maybe asked in exam or repeatedly some short notes, etc., are asked on that. Above factors can be divided into these sub factors like this, that is the meteorological factor, solar radiation, that is the sun rays available, changes depend upon, again, latitude and longitude also. So latitude of the season, time of the day, sky condition, cloudiness, etc. That also affects meteorology, one of the meteorological factor, that is the solar radiation. Air temperature, just now we have discussed. Vapor pressure, again, vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure plus the pressure created by the vapor produced due to evaporation at the surface of the water body or at the surface of the wet soil. Wind velocity, velocity of the air, atmospheric pressure, again the more the atmospheric pressure, lesser will be the evaporation. Nature of the evaporating surface. Vegetation means in case of the soil, वेजिटेशन, मोर वेजिटेशन, मोर मोर फॉरेस्ट, जंगल ज्यादा है तो इवेपोरेशन कम होगा, और यदि बैरन लैंड है जैसे डेजर्ट में वगैरह है तो इवेपोरेशन नेचुरली ज्यादा होगा. हमने अभी देखा पिछला कि इन द डेजर्ट और ऑन द बैरन लैंड 90% ऑफ द प्रेसिपिटेशन गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू इवेपोरेशन. दैट इज अ ह्यूज ह्यूज लॉस. वी आर लूजिंग द नेचुरल रिसोर्सेस टू 90% ऑफ दी वैल्यू. बिल्डिंग्स मीन्स मोर बिल्डिंग्स इन दैट कैचमेंट एरिया, नेचुरली दिस बिल्डिंग्स विल नॉट ओनली अपोज फॉर द पर्कुलेशन ऑफ वाटर बट विल ऑल्सो रेजिस्ट फॉर दी इवेपोरेशन. और समटाइम्स द बिल्डिंग गेट हीटेड एंड मे हेल्प इन समर फॉर द मोर इवेपोरेशन बिकॉज बिल्डिंग्स आर मेड अप ऑफ द कॉन्क्रीट एंड द ब्रिक्स एक्सेट्रा. सो दे एब्जॉर्ब हीट एंड दे ऑल्सो एमिट द हीट. सो दे आर फॉर दे आर नॉट ऑफ यू हेल्पफुल. पेव्ड स्ट्रीट्स यानी जो कॉन्क्रीट के वगैरह रोड होते हैं वो हम देखते हैं धूपकाले में, दे गेट दे रिफ्लेक्ट द एनर्जी, दे रिफ्लेक्ट द हीट एनर्जी. द रोड्स गेट हीटेड इन द समर. दे एब्जॉर्ब द हीट. द कॉन्क्रीट हैज गॉट द टेंडेंसी ऑफ एब्जॉर्बिंग हीट एंड रिलीजिंग इट दैट हीट एनर्जी. सो द पेव्ड स्ट्रीट्स ऑल्सो हेल्प्स इन मोर इवेपोरेशन. सॉइल सर्फेस, अगेन वेट सर्फेस, ड्राई सर्फेस, दी परमिएबल सॉइल, इम्परमिएबल सॉइल, रॉकी सॉइल, स्लोपी सॉइल, ऑल द जियोलॉजिकल एंड जियोग्राफिकल पैरामीटर ऑफ द सॉइल हेल्प्स इन द इवेपोरेशन और may resist the evaporation. Snow and the ice, so in the hilly region, in the where the snow and the ice occurs, that also affects the evaporation. Water quality, as we have discussed, salinity. Salinity means water holding more saline, that is the sodium chloride or the salt. So that evaporation of that water is comparatively lower to the non-saline water. Dissolved solids, more dissolved solids, more energy is needed. Okay. So now, friends, as we have seen, almost 90% of the precipitation gets evaporated due to the solar energy, due to the sun heat. Then what should we do to reduce this evaporation losses? Because these losses plays a very important role of losing the water quantity. As has been seen by me during my service period, I worked on number of the big dams on and around Nagpur, like the Rama Dam. One dam is near Bela. The another is that dam is in near Sadeshwar, Nand Dam. So I worked on that dam for the whole year. I have seen all the three seasons. But in summer, I have seen in this scorching heat of our Vidarbha, reaching to 45, 47, 48 degrees, the water level of the dam reduces. You can understand how much is the surface area of the dam, how big the dam is. The water a quantity of the dam reduces to not less than 30 to 40 centimeters per day in the summer, in the heat of May. That I have experienced because I used to measure the level of the dams. So that much is the devastation caused by the evaporation to the natural resource of the water. Because we use this water for the drinking. We use this water for the irrigation purpose. We use this water in the reservoir for the hydroelectric generation. If on such a larger surface area, which is more than a 50 or 100 square kilometer surface area, I will again repeat, the surface area of those water bodies like the Rama Dam and the Sadeshwar Dam, Nanda Dam it is called as, it's more than 50 or 100 square kilometer. So multiplied by 0.4 or 0.5 meters, if that much quantity of water per day getting evaporated, so how much land or how much people or how much electricity is deprived of the water? You can understand. I think you are understanding the seriousness of the matter. So therefore, there are various methods to reduce the evaporation losses. Okay, this is one of the very important subject for research nowadays. And if somebody comes out with a very good solution, then it can be implemented. Because we are losing, as I have explained you, the seriousness. We are losing how much water in evaporation. Okay. So there are three important methods. One is the reduction of the surface area. Another is mechanical covers, providing mechanical covers, which is a bit impracticable on a larger surface area. On small surface area, it's all right. And the third and the practical, which is used nowadays, is the chemical film. Use of the chemical films. So three you must have noted in your notebook. Methods to reduce the evaporation losses are the reduction of the surface area, mechanical covers, and the chemical films. As has I have shown you here, as per my regular practice, some photographs are shown here. This is the water body, which is being covered by certain chemicals. We'll see one by one. So now we will see first the reduction of the surface area. Because more the surface area of the water body, more it is exposed to the sun, more it is exposed to the sun rays, solar energy, and more will be evaporation. That is the natural thing. As in our area, specifically in the Vidarbha area or the eastern part of the Maharashtra, including the some western part, that is the Amravati, Akola, up to Buldana, etc., or the Bhusawal. All these are the hot wave areas during summer. So the efforts are needed to reduce the evaporation losses. The first is reduction of the surface area. So what to do then? We have seen in earlier that various factors that affect the evaporation, wherein we have seen surface area is one of the factor, and another is depth of the water. More depth of the water, lesser will be the evaporation. Lesser depth of the water, more will be evaporation, because for lesser depth of water, lesser energy will be required for the water molecules to get lifted from the water body, and therefore lesser evaporation, a more evaporation. So therefore measures like having deep reservoirs in a place of wider ones and elimination of the shallow areas can be considered under this measure, under this category. But again, is it in the control of the engineers some extent, it is possible that we will choose the dam site or the reservoir site having lesser surface area and more depth to get more quantity of water. But over and all, sometimes we have to adjust for more water accumulation, more surface area and lesser depth, because everywhere the topography of the land is not same. I think you must be understanding slowly what I mean to say. What I mean to say is that every time it is not possible that you will get the reservoir site, the dam site, which will have lesser surface area and more depth. Like the area in our region, which is flat terrain, wherein if we want to construct a dam, we cannot construct because we don't have hilly area more. Mountains are not here in our area. So we want to construct a dam, then naturally those reservoirs will have more water spread, like the Gosekurt project, like the Rama project, like the Nand, I have said, or maybe the Pench. We have water resources, but our topography is such that we cannot construct the dam having deep depth or deep water depth, which is possible in hilly area, like the Sahyadris, like the Satpuras, like the Himalayas, etc. Okay, but as a civil engineer, we always must keep this point in mind while selecting the dam site, while selecting the reservoir site, to have a site of reduced surface area and more depth. Okay, in our Maharashtra, some dams which are in the Sahyadri ranges, like the dams in Kokand, like the dams in Western Maharashtra. Koyna Dam is one of the best example. Koyna, which supplies maximum of the hydroelectricity to Maharashtra. It is very huge dam. Water quantity is very large, but the water spread is very less. The depth of the water is very huge there, because it is in the Sahyadri ranges. So the loss of the evaporation is very less there. Okay, now we will move on to the second and third. We will be revised tomorrow. Providing the mechanical covers by permanent roofs over the reservoir, or the temporary roofs or floating roofs such as the rafts. Arid lightweight floating particles can be adopted wherever feasible. But definitely, these measures are limited to very small water bodies such as ponds, etc. For small water bodies, because providing the mechanical cover over a large water body is uneconomical. It will need crores of the rupees as compared to the water we are losing in evaporation. Therefore, for a smaller water body, small ponds, we can provide the covers, mechanical covers, shades. But for larger water bodies, it is very difficult. But it can be one of the method, or it can be one of the solution to reduce the evaporation losses. This is nowadays used, that is the use of the chemical films. It consists of applying a thin chemical film over the water body, as has been shown here, to reduce the evaporation. It forms a layer, it forms a film from water body, between water body and atmosphere, and does not allow both to come in contact with each other, so that the heat from the atmosphere will not evaporate the water at the water surface, and will reduce the evaporation to a large extent. This is the only feasible method available for reduction of the evaporation of reservoir up to moderate site. Certain chemical films are there, certain chemicals are there, like the cetyl alcohol, they are also called as hexadecanol, steryl alcohol, octadecanol, form non-molecular layers, monomolecular layers on the water surface. They act as a evaporation inhibitors by preventing the water molecule to escape from the water body. As you must be recalling or you must be remembering, we use the curing compounds over the concrete surface. Certain curing compounds we used to spray on the concrete surface to control the evaporation of the water from the concrete to atmosphere. In the same way, we use these chemical films, which acts as a inhibitor between the water and the sun rays or the atmosphere. What are the features needed from these? What are the properties needed from these films? Those films we are spraying or we are creating above the water surface, these films must be strong. And as there are waves in the water, these must be flexible. These must be strong. These must be flexible. They should be unbreakable as far as possible due to the wave action. Must be self-repairable also. If they are punctured, if they get broken due to the impact of the rainfall or by the birds or by the insects, those films must close back soon after, है ना? वो क्या होना चाहिए? फिर से वो फिल्म टूटने के बाद में वो फिर से जुड़ जाना चाहिए. Those chemical films. A very important thing is expected. It is pervious. It must be pervious to oxygen and carbon dioxide. You have learnt in your last semester, or maybe learning next semester, that oxygen is needed for the decomposition of organic matter in the water body. And after decomposition of the organic matter, the carbon dioxide is emitted. This carbon dioxide is emitted into atmosphere, which purifies the water, self-purification of the water in the stream. So, therefore, these films must be pervious or permeable for the oxygen and the carbon dioxide so that the water quality will not get affected by the film. It should be colorless. It should be odorless and non-toxic, because we are using this water for the agriculture purpose, for the industrial purpose, or for the drinking purpose. So various chemicals are there. We have seen cetyl alcohol. Their quantities are there. We have discussed earlier cetyl alcohol type of the chemicals are there. So friends, here today we will take the break. We will continue the remaining part in our next lecture. Don't leave the class.